there, I'm Lisa Glantz. Today I'm going to show you how to create a super fast logo using my latest font called Salt and Pepper. This font's pretty special because it's only available on Design Cuts. Plus, we've included some awesome free bonus graphics for you to use in your next design project. We've included a free sample pack as part of this tutorial, which includes the logo I created, all the related graphics, plus the two textures I used. Okay, so let's get started. The first thing you want to do is create a document to your desired size. I'm working on a long rectangular shape because ultimately I want to create a logo plus design a website header image. I'm going to use some of the bonus graphics that come with the font. I prefer to work in layers to keep things neat and easy to access. To create a new layer, just click on the new layer icon in your layers palette and give it a name. I've gone ahead and chosen my color palette and created my background color. The logo I'll be designing is for a photographer. I'm using her initials to create a monogram and combine it with her full name. The first thing I'm going to do is create a text box for her initials. I'm now going to use the alternative characters that are included in the font. To access these alternatives, you need to open your Glyphs panel, which is under the Type menu. Once you have the panel open, you can access all the font's features from the drop-down menu. If you select Alternatives for current selection, it'll show all the available options you have for that letter. I'm going to go ahead and choose this one. I'm now going to do the same for the letter T. I think that looks pretty cool. The next step is to add her full name underneath. I'll be using the Salt and Pepper sans serif for that. Now we can add the word photography under that. I'm just going to change the color and increase the tracking. I also want to give that word a slight curve. The easiest way to do that would be to use the warp effect. So under the menu Effect, select Warp and then Arc. From there you can set your amount. I'm going to go with approximately minus 25, maybe minus 26. As a finishing touch, I'm going to add a small decorative element. Again, you want to open the Glyphs panel to access all the different ornaments. The font also includes a handy reference sheet for the ornaments if you don't want to choose that via the Glyphs panel. I'm going to go with these. I want to add a line or a dash either side. For this, I'm simply going to use the dashes from the Salt and Pepper script. To make these a little less clumsy to work with, I'm going to convert these to outlines, which is under Type menu, Create Outlines. Then I'll group them. The next step would be to check that all your elements are aligned. You can do this via your Align panel. I'm going to use Align to Artboard because I want the logo centered on my background. Okay, perfect. I think that's looking pretty good. Now that we've completed the logo, I'm going to go ahead and create the rest of my header image. I've already selected the graphics I want to use, and I'm just going to dot these around to create a casual look. I'd like to run the border across the bottom, but I only want to use some of it. So I'm going to delete the ones that I want to use. The wreath I want to use in the middle of my design, just to frame the logo and add a lovely feminine touch to the piece. For a finishing touch, I'm going to add some texture. Included in the ornaments are three fun texture glyphs. They're really easy to use and super versatile. The corresponding keyboard equivalent is lowercase a, b, and c. You can use a combination of the three. You can use them over several lines and add spaces in between, increase the leading and kerning to create different effects. I've used two layers of textures, which are different colors, for even more variation. And that's it. You now have a logo plus a header image in no time at all. I hope that you love working with salt and pepper, and if you have any questions at all, please do let us know in the comments below.